I have an old friend Alex. For the last 5-6 years, his computer is in my mind, synonymous with pain and shabbiness. That'd be okay if he weren't my ally in CSGO, and I've seen his computer's reaction to this game. A couple of months ago, it went like this. You charge onto the enemy, the image freezes for a second, and the next thing you know is you're dead. It doesn't feel good when you lose, not because of your poor gaming skills. His computer is so bad, the files it copied for this video turned out to be corrupted, so if you see the picture jumping, you know who to blame. Apparently, there have been a few patches lately that lowered the load on a PC, as now it doesn't freeze completely, but back then, these manipulations were quite effective. The root of all evils was his processor. He has AMD A4-5300 and it's a bad processor. If you're going to purchase something for this amount of money, don't make a mistake. Buy a new Celeron instead. There are two ways to approach this issue. Increase the power of the weakest components or lower the load on them. As usual, ways to unload the processor aren't working anymore. We've only got a bad picture without affecting the overall result. We will use the following commands in the launch options. First off, we'll product a couple of tests to proceed from. WinRAR showed 1344 kilobytes per second, Cinebench 104, and the temperature on load was around 85 degrees. Back to the game, its minimum FPS is 21 with small freezes, and its average in Dust 2 Deathmatch with a mob of players is 39. There is also an option to download an improvised benchmark, and its minimum and average frame rates were 11 and 41 respectively. The thing is, this construction is held in the place literally with a single screw and a lace. You can cover yourself in the layer of its dust, so I'll tidy everything up. All this dust can have negative effect on the temperature of the processor, which I'm going to overclock very soon. By the way, this model doesn't have an unlocked multiplier, and the motherboard itself is razor simple, so we'll just increase the base clock, speeding up the memory controller at the same time. Having bought a new computer case, I've got enough spare screws to apply them to Alex's computer. However, slots where these screws should have gone had a different threads, so I've managed to screw in only two of them. While I was busy with the main problem, I could also deal with his mouse, it has its issues. It performs fairly well in games, it just moves on a bare table and its glides are worn out. It's uncomfortable, it's loud, why not fix it? We sure need a mouse pad. I just happen to have a spare QCK by SteelSeries, but you can also have an A4Tech analog and the result will be almost the same. We can borrow glides from an old mouse, as lucky we had one. Believe me, these changes are worth it. While I was cleaning the heatsink, I came to think it was no good, as first of all, it was small, lightweight and made of aluminum, and second of all, it didn't overlay the processor cover, so even if we reapplied thermal grease, we shouldn't have expected much. If you watched my previous video where I compared G4560 and Core i3, you know that dual channel mode is not just wish-wash. It's especially dramatic for our CPU, as amount of other things, it has small cache size, so high-speed RAM will come in handy. The second stick removes some load on processor. As I have already said, I'll slightly increase its base clock by 8%. I could have increased it a little more, but firstly, this motherboard is not particularly stable after overclocking, and secondly, the processor was constantly dropping clock speed due to heat. Despite my cleaning, the temperature increased even more, so it's definitely mean heatsink replacement. So what are the changes that resulted from overclocking and launch options? Cinebench and RAR rates increased, which is good. The changes in Deathmatch and Benchmark are pretty noticeable too. Average FPS increased by about 30%, although its minimum rate remains on the same poor level. You need to keep in mind that FPS does not reflect the real picture, as with low refresh rate there were also constant freezes and general lack of smoothness. Although 55 is not exactly the most comfortable average FPS for Counter-Strike, there are far more less objects to process in competitive mode, so the processor shows a higher frame rate.
And now I see that Alex's issue was not just his computer.